17 and starting at verse 22 to 23. Amen. Again, it's Acts 17, verse 22 to 23. And it reads, "And then Paul stood in the midst of the Areopagus and said, 'Men of Athens, I perceive in all things you are very religious. For as I was passing through and considering the objects of your worship, I even found an altar with an inscription, to the unknown God. Therefore, the one whom you worship without knowing, him I proclaim to you.'" Amen. And I just want to give you guys a brief definition of the word unknown. And some synonyms to the word unknown means not known or familiar. Amen. It means uncertain, undisclosed, unrevealed, secret, undetermined, undecided, unresolved, unsettled, and unsure. Amen. And we read in this passage in Acts 17, and Apostle Paul was, you know, he was waiting for the rest of the apostles at Athens, right? And the Bible says that his spirit was provoked because he went to this city and he saw the city was given over to idols. And therefore, the Bible says he reasoned in the synagogues with the Jews and with the Gentile worshipers. So we see in this passage that these were people of God because he said he reasoned in the synagogues with the Jews and with the Gentile worshipers. Amen. And what we've been reading in Bible study all week is that, you know, for the last couple weeks, is that, you know, there's a shaking coming to the body of Christ. And there's a shaking as God is doing within us, that everything that can be shaken will be shaken. Amen. And I remember one time I was working out and I heard the Lord say to me, he said, "Vontrice," because he gave me a word a few years ago, and he said, "Everything that can be shaken, it will be shaken." And then he said to me, "Go get your word." And so I had got off the treadmill and I went and got my word, and I was like, "Okay, Lord." And then the God began to deal with me is that you got to begin to come so sure about me through the word of God. And many of us are like the people that were in Athens, the men of Athens. We come to church every day. We worship God, like Pastor was saying today, because he told the Apostle Paul said to the Athens, he said, "I perceive in all things you are very religious." And some of us, when we think, when people tell us we're very religious, I believe that the men of Athens took that as a pride of joy. They said, "Yeah, we religious. We know the ways of God. We know how to lift our hands. We know how to praise. We know how to sing all the good songs. We know to shout. We know how to jump up and down." But Paul said, the Bible says that Paul was provoked in his spirit. Why? Because they didn't know the true and living God. Amen. So you can sometimes come to the house of God, and you can come, like Pastor said, and sit in the same seat, but something about revelation that causes you to know who God is to you. Amen. Pastor can't know it for you. Apostle can't know it for you. You know, the elders of the church can't know it for you. But God is causing the body of Christ to know who he is. Many of us, you know, we may say, okay, we don't have a physical inscription that says to the unknown God. But God says when situations arise, when things come to shake your very foundation, you begin to become uncertain, unsure, or in doubt. But the Bible says when you know who God is, you're able to say in the midst of adversity, you're able to say when all hell's breaking loose, you're able to say that when you're going through some rough things, that you're able to say, "I know who my God is. I know that my God is a healer. I know that my God is a deliverer. I know that my God is a way maker." Some of us are getting bent out of shape about bills. Some of us are getting bent out of shape about the things that are going on in our family. But God says, "Do you know who I am? Do you know that I make ways out of no ways? Do you know that I am Jehovah God?" So I came on today to be an apostle Paul to you, to stand of your worship. The objects of worship. The mic, the keyboard, the drum. Hold on one second. And it also says something that's been unresolved. Is there some issues in you with your relationship with God that you're going to have to resolve? And the only way you can resolve that is in His Word. Like Pastor said, you know, the earth and the heavens are going to pass away, but not His Word. And I believe that's why God said, Montrese, get your Word. That means get in my Word. That way, when things come up against you, you got the surety of His Word. There's some things that only His Word can do. Not your emotions, not your feelings, not your family, not your best friend. Only His Word is going to be able to secure us, to cause us to never be shaken. I declared that this will be the season for me of God's confidence in me. And I said that this will be the season of confidence. That way I will become not confident in myself, because I'm like, sometimes I don't know which way I'm coming or going. But I said, Lord, I want to be confident in You. The You that's in me, the God that's in me. I want to be sure. That way when you tell me to do something, I don't waver no longer. But I trust You that's in me to do it. And you may say, well, my issue is not worship, or I know who God is. But just like Minister Evangelist Lisa declared on today, some of us are stuck in fear. And you won't move. You still are. To God, you are worshiping like you don't know Him. But if you know God, it will provoke you to move out of the place that you're in. Fear, the only fear is nothing but doubt, uncertainty. You become fearful when you're not sure about something. But God says, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. He said, I'll be with you even until the ends of the earth. Meaning He's with us. He's the God that is with us. So if He's with me, I'm not by myself. When I got up this morning, I heard the Lord say, you know, if I be for you, who can be against you? Who can be against you if I'm before you? See, this is why we got to become confident in God and not in ourselves. Like Pastor said, when you become confident in yourself, you start to take stuff personal. But when you become confident in who God is, you say, God, that's all You. You said if You be for me, so that ain't even hit me. So, you know, I just came to encourage you guys on today. Be confident in who God is. Don't no longer worship like you don't know who He is. And worship is a lifestyle. I'm not talking about, you know, lifting your hands, hallelujah. It's a lifestyle. It's obedience. That when God says do something, you do it. Not out of what you know about you, but what you know about Him. The God that is in you. So, you know, just like Paul said to the Athens, you know, I came to proclaim to you, to remind you of the God that you serve. I came to remind you of who He is in you. The Bible says, if greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. There's a greater one in you. So we don't act like the world. We don't get bent out of shape when we look at the news. We don't get in debates with the world about the events of the world. Why? Because we have the surety of the Word of God. It is His Word that stands, even through the test of time. Get in His Word. Bask in His Word. Meditate on His Word day and night. David said, you know, Your Word have I hid in my heart. We got to hide the Word in our hearts. Because disobedience is sin. So you may say, I don't smoke and I don't drink, but God says go, do you go? When God says, okay, it's time for you to, you know, step walk in ministry, y'all, I just want to share with y'all, last night, I was so, just getting on my word, I was so frustrated. God had already gave me the word that He wanted me to say, but I was just like, Lord, this ain't it. You know, that's why I said, God, this ain't it. And I wrestled, y'all, I was up all night, I was freaking out. I said, Lord Jesus, and then I started saying, Lord, I don't want to do it. I was like, Lord, I said, you know, Apostle is good for this. You know, Pastor Matt is good for this. You know, and all the other ministers, but Lord, not me. And God began to, you know, deal with me, Montrese. He's like, Montrese, you got to do what I say do. Because your ignorance before I overlooked. But now it's time for you to come up. It's time for you to arrive to a place. That's why when Evangelist Lisa was declaring, you know, about fear, I said, she on my road. She talking about me. Lord, okay, Lord, it's me. I'm in the house. So, you know, I just, you know, don't be fearful. in this season. Allow God to be God in you. Amen.
Amen.